Welcome back to the channel, everyone, and thank you for joining me. This is the 10th video in my origin series, which explores family history research and several of the haplogroups that exist in my ancestry, including my paternal and maternal genetic groups. The series includes a few how-to videos, including how to begin researching your family history, how to get past those early parish records, break down walls, and how to publish your family history. These are all videos planned over the coming weeks, so if any of the subjects interest you, then please keep watch for those upcoming videos. This series of films go live every Monday at 12 noon, British Standard Time. Today's video takes a look at my two times great-grandfather, Theodorus Fedyszyn, his paternal Y-DNA haplogroup, a group called I-S17250. The age of this mutation is estimated at roughly 1,800 years. The group is a subclade of 1-2-A-1-B, which was a patriarch line of two separate subclades, L161.1 and L621. For the purpose of this video, it is the L621 line that we are interested in, and the one we will focus on in this video. The following chart shows the phylogenetic tree of haplogroup 1-2. You will see on the chart that haplogroup 1-6-2-1 falls within the Mesolithic period, and as we follow that lineage down, you will see that S17250 is one of the subclades that belong to CTS10228. S17250 is a Slavic haplogroup that broke away during the Iron Age period. Haplogroup 1-2-A1b-L621. This branch is found overwhelmingly in Slavic countries. Its maximum frequencies are observed among the Dinaric Slavs, Slovenes, Croats, Bosniaks, Serbs, Montenegrins and Macedonians, as well as in Bulgaria, Romania, Moldavia, Western Ukraine and Belarus. It is also common to a lower extent in Albania, Greece, Hungary, Slovakia, Poland, and southwestern Russia. I2L621 is also known as I2a-DIN, which stands for Dinaric. The high concentration of I2a1b-L621 in northeast Romania, Moldova and central Ukraine reminds of the maximum spread of a Cucuteni-Trypillian culture, 4,800 to 3,000 BCE. No Y-DNA samples of this culture has been tested to date, but as it evolved as an offshoot from the Starkevo-Koros-Kris culture, it is likely that I2A was one of the main paternal lineages, and a founder effect could have increased considerably its frequency. The Trypillian culture was the most advanced Neolithic culture in Europe before the Indo-European invasions in the Bronze Age, and seems to have intense contacts with the steppe culture. From 3500 BC, at the onset of the Yamna period in the Pontic-Caspian Steppe, the Trypillian people started expanding east into the steppe of what is now Western Ukraine, leaving their towns the largest in the world at the time and adopting an increasingly nomadic lifestyle like the Yamna neighbours. It can easily be imagined that Trypillian people became assimilated by those Yamna neighbours and that they spread as a minority lineage alongside haplogroups R1a and R1b as they advanced towards the Baltic and the Corded Ware expansion. Alternatively, I2 L621 lineages could have lived in relative isolation from the mainstream Proto-Indo-European society somewhere around Ukraine, Poland or Belarus. Then, as the centuries and millennia passed, would have blended with the predominantly R1a populations around them. The resulting amalgam would have become the ancestors of the Proto-Slavs nowadays. I2A1 is 5 to 10 times more common than G2A in Southeast Europe, while during the Neolithic period, G2A was approximately 4 times more common. What can explain this complete reversal? At one point in history, I2A1 lineages seem to have benefited from being on the winning side. Apart from a minor boost from possibly joining Yamna's westward expansion to Europe, the principal determining event that allowed I2A1b-L621 to become a major Eastern European lineage was probably the Slavic migrations from the 6th to the 9th century CE. Most modern Eastern Europeans belonging to I2A1b fit into the CTS10228 subclade, which is thought to have arisen 5,600 years ago, just before the Yamna period and the Trypillian expansion into the steppe. The minority of I2A1b L621 individuals negative for CTS10228 are all found around Eastern Poland, Belarus and Western Ukraine, suggesting that this is where the lineage survived since the Chalcolithic. The I2A1b CTS10228 subclade seems to have expanded very fast from 1,900 years ago, which is concordant with the timing of the Slavic ethnogenesis. Considering that it takes a few centuries before one man can have enough male descendants to start having an impact at the scale of a small but fast-growing population, after Germanic tribes living in Eastern Germany and Poland, like the Goths, the Vandals and the Burgundians, invaded the Roman Empire, the Slavs from further east filled the vacuum. Following the collapse of the Western Roman Empire in 476, the Slavs moved in the Dinaric Alps and the Balkans. By the 9th century, the Slavs occupied all modern Slavic-speaking territories, apart from the Eastern Balkans, which was under control of the Turkic-speaking Bulgars. Nowadays, northern Slavic countries have between 9% Poland and 21% Ukraine of I2A1621. Whilst southern Slavs have between 20% Bulgaria and 50% Bosnia, the higher percentage of I2A Din in the south is probably just due to another founder effect, due to the fact that the South Slavs originated in Western Ukraine, where the ratio of I2A and R1A was higher. Virtually all Dinaric I2A falls under the CTS10228 subclade. and the majority to the S17250 ramification, who descended from a common patrilinear ancestor who lived only 1,800 years ago. So this haplogroup is by far the youngest we have studied in these videos. The connection with the Trypillian culture is also of big interest to me, as I have an interest in that particular culture and have a couple of items in my collection made by that ancient group of people. They include a flint sickle, shown here in this photograph, and my favourite of all, a Trypillian culture ceramic bowl. In all probability, these two items were made by my long forgotten ancestors. The Cucuteni-Trypillia culture was a Neolithic Eastern European culture that existed 5,500 to 2,750 BCE. In my own lineage, I can trace my Fedyszyn line back to my fifth great-grandfather, Theodorus Fedyszyn of Kamano, Eastern Galicia. He was born in 1774 and died in 1841 in Piaski, Kamano. This is a lineage I have a DNA match with too, in regards to my autosomal DNA, which covers all of your ancestors. My ancestors in this line includes the known patriarch of the family, my fifth great-grandfather, Theodorus, born 1774. My fourth great-grandfather, Basilius Fedyszyn, born in 1800. My third great-grandfather, Johannes Fedyszyn, born in 1838. My two times great-grandfather, Theodorus Fedyszyn, born in 1858. And my great-grandmother, Katarzyna Fedyszyn, born in 1899. Of course, Katarzyna would not carry the Y-DNA, as this marker is not traceable in women, but her male ancestors do descend from this haplogroup. I have a couple more haplogroup videos coming up in this series, and a few have been published already. So if you're interested in DNA and any of the groups covered, then please do check those videos out. Next week is the 11th video in this origin series, and I will be taking a look at the haplogroup R-C-T-S-2-5-0-9. So until next week, a big thank you for joining me. Stay safe, keep well, and bye for now. Bye, everybody.